हेलो
स्टार्ट
हेलो गुड इवनिंग डियर डॉक्टर्स ഇന്നിവിടെ ഐ എച്ച് എം എ ട്രിവാൻഡ്രവും ഐ എച്ച് എം എ പിറവും ചേർന്ന് സംഘടിപ്പിക്കുന്ന കോവിഡ് ടോക്ക് ആണ് നടക്കാൻ പോകുന്നത്. എല്ലാവർക്കും ഇപ്പോൾ ലോക്ക്ഡൌണിൽ വലിയൊരു ആശ്വാസമാണ് ഈ കോവിഡ് ഡിസ്കഷൻ. ആക്ച്വലി ഇത് ഡെയിലി വളരെ കോൺഫിഡൻസ് കൂട്ടുന്ന ഒരു ഇതാണ്. കാര്യം നമുക്ക് പ്രാക്ടീസ് ചെയ്യാനും ഇപ്പോ പുതിയ സെക്കൻഡ് വേവില് വരുന്ന ചേഞ്ചസും കാര്യങ്ങളൊക്കെ ഡെയിലി ഡിസ്കസ് ചെയ്യുമ്പോൾ നമുക്ക് ഡോക്ടേഴ്സിന് എല്ലാവർക്കും അതൊരു വളരെ സപ്പോർട്ടാണ് ഐ എച്ച് എമ്മയുടെ ഭാഗത്തു നിന്നുള്ളത്. ഇപ്പൊ ട്രിവാൻഡ്രത്തായാലും വളരെ കൂടുതൽ കേസസ് ഡെയിലി വരുന്നുണ്ട്. സോ ഇന്നത്തെ ഡിസ്കഷൻ നമുക്ക് ആരംഭിക്കാം. അതിന് തൊട്ടു മുമ്പായി ദീപു ഡോക്ടറെ ക്ഷണിക്കുന്നു.
Good evening, everyone. I'm really happy that we made 4 sessions in Ernakulam on IHMA Corona Talk. All of them was very much successful. അപ്പൊ ഞങ്ങൾക്ക് വളരെ ഒരു ഇൻസ്പിറേഷൻ ആയിരുന്നു ഇങ്ങനെ ഒരു സെഷനുമായിട്ട് മുന്നോട്ട് പോകുന്നതിന്. അപ്പം ട്രിവാൻഡ്രവുമായി ചേർന്നുകൊണ്ട് ഒരു കൊറോണ സീരീസ് ഞങ്ങൾ ഇവിടെ എറണാകുളത്താണ് പ്ലാൻ ചെയ്തിരുന്നത്. അപ്പം ഇപ്പൊ നമ്മൾ 4 സെഷൻസ് നടത്തിയിരുന്നു, എന്റെ 10 ഫിസിയോളജിയും ബാക്കിയുള്ള സെഷൻസ് നമ്മൾ നടത്തിയിരുന്നു 4 എണ്ണം. സജീവ് സാറിന്റെ ഉണ്ടായിരുന്നു. അപ്പൊ റസലാണ് ഇങ്ങനെ ഒരു ഡോക്ടർ റസലാണ് ഇതിനൊരു പറഞ്ഞത് നമുക്ക്. അങ്ങനെയാണെങ്കിൽ നമുക്ക് ഡെയിലി ടോക്സ് വെച്ച് ആളുകൾക്ക് കൂടുതലൊരു കോൺഫിഡൻസ് വരുത്തുന്ന രീതിയിൽ നമുക്ക് ചെയ്യാമെന്ന് പറഞ്ഞത്. അപ്പം ഇന്ന് ജോസ് ഐസക് സാറിന്റെ സെഷനാണ്. അപ്പൊ നമ്മുടെ നോർത്ത് ഇന്ത്യയിലുള്ള ഓഡിയൻസിനും കൂടെ വേണ്ടിയിട്ടാണ് ഇതൊരു ബൈലിംഗുൾ ആയിട്ട് ഇംഗ്ലീഷ് സെഷൻ ആയിട്ട് തന്നെ ചെയ്യാന്ന് പറഞ്ഞത്. അപ്പൊ നമ്മളിപ്പം നമുക്ക് ഏകദേശം ഒരു 90-100 ആളുകളായിട്ടുണ്ട്. വളരെ കുറച്ച് സമയത്തെ കൊണ്ടാണെങ്കിലും നമുക്ക് ഇത്രയും ആളുകൾ വന്നത് നമ്മളുടെ ആ ഒരു ഈ സിഗ്നിഫിക്കൻസ് ഈ ഒരു കൊറോണ എന്ന് പറയുന്ന ഒരു സബ്ജക്റ്റിന്റെ സിഗ്നിഫിക്കൻസ് കൊണ്ടാണ് ഇത്രയും ആളുകൾ ഇത് കേൾക്കാനായിട്ട് വരുന്നത്. അപ്പം അവരെല്ലാവർക്കും ഐ എച്ച് എമ്മയുടെ സ്വാഗതം ചെയ്യാണ്. ഐ വെൽക്കം എവ്രി വൺ ഹു ആർ ഫ്രം കേരള ആൻഡ് എബ്രോഡ്. സോ അധികമൊന്നും പറയാനില്ല. ആകെ പറയാനുള്ളത് നമുക്ക് നല്ല ടൈമാണ്. അപ്പം എല്ലാവരും കൊറോണ കേസ് കോൺഫിഡൻ്റ് ആയിട്ട് ഫോണിൽ ടെലിഫോൺ കൺസൾട്ടേഷനിലൂടെ ട്രീറ്റ് ചെയ്യണം. ഇത്തരത്തിലുള്ള സെഷൻസ് നമ്മൾ ഇനിയും എല്ലാ ദിവസവും 7:30 തൊട്ട് നമ്മളുണ്ട്. അപ്പോൾ എല്ലാവരും എല്ലാ ദിവസവും കയറണമെന്ന് ഞങ്ങൾ നിങ്ങളുടെ എല്ലാവരുടെ സപ്പോർട്ട് വേണം. സോ ഐ വെൽക്കം എവ്രി വൺ ടു ദിസ് സെഷൻ വൺസ് അഗെയിൻ ആൻഡ് ഓവർ ടു യു ഡോക്ടർ ലക്ഷ്മി. താങ്ക് യു
ഡോക്ടർ ദീപു. അടുത്തതായി ഇവിടെ ഇന്ന് നമുക്ക് വന്നിരിക്കുന്ന ഡോക്ടർ ജോസ് ഐസക്.
ഇംഗ്ലീഷ് കാൻ യു സ്പീക്ക് ഇൻ ഇംഗ്ലീഷ് ബെറ്റർ ബിക്കോസ് ഓക്കേ.
ടുഡേ വി ഹാവ് എ ഫാക്കൽറ്റി ഡോക്ടർ ജോസ് ഐസക്. ഹി വാസ് ഹെഡ് ഓഫ് ഡിപ്പാർട്ട്മെന്റ് ആൻഡ് പ്രൊഫസർ ഇൻ ദ ഗവൺമെന്റ് ഹോമിയോപതിക് മെഡിക്കൽ കോളേജ് ട്രിവാൻഡ്രം. ഹി ഈസ് നൗ ദ വിസിറ്റിംഗ് പ്രൊഫസർ ഇൻ ദ ഫ്രണ്ട്ഷിപ്പ് യൂണിവേഴ്സിറ്റി മോസ്കോ. He was the member of Central Council of Homeopathy and Education Committee constituted by the Government of India to control the homeopathic education and practice in homeopathy. He was the chairman of the Finance Committee of Central Council of Homeopathy and also the Committee for Excellence in Homeopathic Education constituted by Government of India. He was also the chairman of the Postgraduate Board of Studies in Homeopathy in the University of Kerala. Now he is the director of the Dr. Isaac Homeopathy Center and Dr. Isaac Academy of Homeopathy. Dr. Isaac Joes, the fourth generation homeopath, is an MD in homeopathy and is an assistant professor in the White Memorial Homeopathic Medical College. Welcome you, sir.
Thank you for your introduction. So today we are in the midst of the second wave of COVID pandemic, and it is more fatal, or the death rate is more than in the first wave. So this has to be, we have to deal with it, because in the first wave, homeopathy could do many things around the world. And one thing I have noted is, one company like Ethnic Health Court. They put a video of me suggesting arsenic alb as the preventive for corona, and it has they put in three small pieces, and already it has passed 600,000 or 6 lakh people have seen it, and most of them outside India. And I got many calls from many parts of the world, even Kenya or places where homeopathy is not popular or where homeopathy is not much known. But the good thing was Amazon and Flipkart was selling this preventive arsenic album, and it helped homeopathy to reach every corner of the world. So that helped a lot. And now again, we are facing the second wave. So we are again in the midst of a pandemic where it is active. And in the last first wave, the percentage of death in Kerala state was less than 0.5%. And homeopathy is one of the reasons why we could bring it down to this level. So here what we have to understand is how to manage this pandemic. Now more and more people are coming to homeopathy because slowly the confidence in homeopathy around the world is increasing and increasing. And every pandemic or every epidemic helped homeopathy to grow in different parts of the world, starting from our scarlet fever, then the cholera epidemic in India. And many times, all these epidemics, the first option was homeopathy. It is because homeopathy is based on symptomatology. Our prescription is based on symptomatology and not any organism based. That means, as we can see in the last 15 years, in India also, what we have seen is the one after another, the epidemics are coming every 3 years or 4 years. And most of these epidemics, the organism which was there in animals and domestic animals around us become more stronger and slowly affect the human beings also. So here what we can say is, these pandemics, these epidemics are not going to stop, because first it was a bird flu, then the mad cow disease, then the pig flu, the H1N1, then chikungunya. So when we look back, we can see that many of the viruses or bacteria which were present in the domestic animals or animals around us, slowly becoming more stronger and affecting the human beings also. So in this context, we have to remember one more thing. A warning given by one of the WHO officials in 2015 in the Geneva conference, what he said is, this indiscriminate use of antibiotics will lead to more mutant strains of the bacteria and viruses. This was said by Robert Chan. You can get it in the, you can go through the whole speech of Dr. Robert Chan in the WHO website. You can go to the internet and find out. So what he has said is, if you give this antibiotics in this rate, it will slowly boomerang, and it will affect the human beings also. So here, and also what he said is, all the animals around us, all the domestic animals or animals living around us are also getting these antibiotics one way or other, because all the farms, they are having protocols like every 3 months they are giving antibiotics, or 2 months or something, they are keep on giving these antibiotics. And you know, the genetic theory, the evolution, And any human being, any living being, when it is killed, slowly they will survive these problems. They will be able to survive it by going for mutation and producing more mutant, stronger variety. So this is what is going on. Then that's the reason why I said this phenomena will continue, because in the last 100 years, what we could see is the so-called modern medicine survived mainly because of the antibiotics and vaccinations. And this has become a big business and one of the most profitable business. And you can see in American president election, pharma companies are the ones who are donating the highest amount of money for the presidential election. So this is why it is happening so. So in America, we know there are around 45, 50 plus vaccines. Some are very popular. And they were distributing or they were giving flu vaccines for the last 40 years. Even then, they couldn't contain it. And every year, they are giving new vaccines, not the old one. Because these viruses are undergoing mutation, and every year, new strains of bacteria, new, more and more stronger strains of bacteria are coming, and the viruses are coming. And then they need to change the vaccine also. So this same thing will happen to the whole world in a span of 5 or 10 years. So this is the situation. And I hope that this will lead to a new thinking in the field of medicine. Because we know that the human beings and the technology, everything is improving day by day. But in the case of health, we were following a wrong line of treatment, and the whole world was promoting it. Why I say the whole world is because we know that the World Health Organization came into existence after the Second World War, and it's almost 75 years now, almost between 70 and 75 years. The WHO is existing here. But even now, they did not accept that any other system other than allopathy could even cure a single simple fever. When we look into that, they will say several studies are coming, several things are going on. So how long it will go on? Even after 75 years, they couldn't identify a single system that can cure even a single fever other than modern medicine. So that's why we say the WHO is a B team of the pharmaceutical companies. We know that at the same time, in the 2019 report of the WHO, they say 40% of the world population are depending on traditional and complementary medicine. So at the same time, they are saying this in the report, because there are many studies are conducted on this, and they got the reports from different countries, and finally they gave the report. But they are not ready to accept or recognize many systems of medicine. So they have put it in the traditional and complementary medicine group. Homeopathy stands first, because homeopathy is the cheapest, safest, and the one which is available throughout the globe. Or you can even bring it through some marketing agencies or something. So homeopathy became popular not only because of its effectiveness, but because of its availability globally. We know the second one is Chinese medicine, and the third is Ayurveda. And the next one comes the acupuncture, osteopathy, many other systems. They have put 6 systems of medicine under the traditional and complementary medicine. The most popular one among them is homeopathy. Okay, then coming back to our topic. this COVID pandemic has opened a new idea in a way. That means the idea was there, but it was not accepted in a big way, that we have to depend on the total immunity or natural immunity. And as is written in our Stuart Close philosophy, Stuart Close says that a medicine should be, okay, I will. So Stuart Close says that the medicine should be not only the one which can cure diseases, it should be one which can increase the immunity of the patient. So this is what homeopathy is doing. So now a shift, a paradigm shift is coming up in the field of medicine. That means even modern medicine doctors have started talking about general immunity, because through the last 100 years, after the advent of the antibiotic and the vaccinations, these two were pointing towards specific immunity against the bacteria or the virus or whatever it is. So now there is a shift. The people have started thinking differently. People today, I have been watching one webinar by one of the leading doctors in Kerala. What he was saying is people should concentrate on general immunity, because that is the only way you can get rid of the diseases. Especially when new strains of bacteria are coming, what he says is it will take 2 or 3 years to come up with a vaccine. And until that time, they can't do anything at all, because their medicines are disease specific. That is the biggest problem now. So this shift should come in the field of medicine. That means a medicine is the one which must be able to induce general immunity. And in as our homeopathic principle says, this by enhancing the general immunity, you can throw away the disease, you can eliminate the disease from each individual. So this is the basic difference and basic thinking in our field of medicine. And our stand, or Hanuman's stand, from the very beginning was to improve the immunity or the strengthen the vital force and thereby throw out the disease. And that is vindicated now. Every epidemic is repeatedly proving that only by enhancing the general immunity or enhancing the vital force, you can cure diseases. And the stream which they were following is wrong. And it can only produce more mutant varieties of the bacteria, virus, or parasite, or whatever it is. So this is being proved in this. It took around 100 years, because these vaccines and everything came 100 years back. And in the beginning of this epidemic itself, we have heard that the WHO is saying that there is no specific medicine for this. There is no vaccination for this. The only thing is you can give symptomatic treatment. And this symptomatic treatment is homeopathy. So that's why I said this has opened a new venues for homeopathy. And even, you know, there are many things, the many concepts in medicine is changing now. We also know that in the last last year, when the epidemic first appeared, everybody was told that there is only airborne infection. And we were prevented from, we were asked to wear the mask, to wash the hands with the sanitizers, keep distance of 1 meter or 3 feet like that. Now the latest study shows that this virus can affect a person who is standing 6 feet from the infected individual. So in the coming days, you will see many new things coming up, because whatever they were following throughout the world will be found a foolery, because when this new epidemics come, they cannot easily contain them, And even though such a history is, thing is here, the first thing they are doing is to prevent the other systems from treating these diseases. So the audio is okay?
Sir, audio correct. A range issue. Please check your range, okay? The mobile range. It is because of their mobile range, they are not getting the talk.
Okay, so sir. From my part, it is okay.
No. If you are, no. Your part is correct, sir. Yeah.
Okay. So coming to this treatment of corona, that's our topic today. I have the experience of treating around 200, 300 cases now, because every day people are coming, but some of them have not taken the test for COVID, and some are abroad. And we have getting very good results from this because we are treating according to the symptom. And that's one of the reasons why I say that even if these mutant varieties are coming in the coming days, homeopathy will be effective. Because we are not bothered about what strain is causing this particular disease. We are not bothered about whether it is influenza A, B, or C, or whatever it is. And the symptoms are almost the same, but there are individual variations. So here, while I was, before going to the topic, let me say one more thing. While I was going through my father's textbook of practice of medicine, written by Price, that was published, I think, around 75 years back. So there I have found a very interesting thing. That means the influenza, flu, the classification is cerebral flu, gastric flu, pyretic flu. Like that, there are, I found some classifications. Actually, I think that classification is much better than the present classification of this influenza virus. So because of that, this is very, and respiratory flu, that is another type. So here, what they mean by this is, we know that the typical presentation, the symptoms are fever, dry cough, weakness, breathlessness, sore throat, headache, nausea, vomiting, everything. But there are people who starts with a loose motion. They don't have much fever, but starting with a loose motion or diarrhea. And in such cases, what I have found is the best remedy is to start with is Nexomycia. So Nexomycia is working very well in that conditions. A few doses of Nexomycia, and before going to that, I wanted to tell you about the potency and the repetition also, because that will be interesting for you. Anyway, what I usually do, I am just wanted to share with you. Maybe it will help you. You can also try, and if found useful, you can also use it. So here, the potency used is usually 200 potency in fevers, and I used to in a very strong case or a very acute case, I used to repeat one pill of 200 potency morning, noon, and evening, 3 times a day, depending on the intensity. If the patient is recovering, these 3 times will come to 2 times or 1 time, like that. So going to the prescription. The prescription always is, what we have to look for is basically what I have used is only the flu remedies, the common flu remedies, like aconite, belladonna, that is for the first day or the very, very beginning, or as is given in our materia medica, the first stage of inflammation. Then the remedies that comes are arsenic, gelsemium, rostox, bryonia, Nexomycia, pulsatilla. These are the remedies which I usually use in the active phase of or a fever phase of this COVID. And later, some people develop cough, and just like a flu, you know, the more stronger variety. And so usually what I use is, I use the rubric cough after influenza. And the main remedy that I usually use is Sanguinaria and Sticta. Another important thing which we observe is some people it starts with a severe weakness. If it is severe weakness, the best remedy to start with is arsenic album 200. And if it is with, I told you, all these are common symptoms of COVID. And what we are looking according to our homeopathic principle is what is uncommon among the commons. This is what we are looking for. So the symptom which stands above the other symptoms of flu, that should be given prime importance. And the modality will be more clearer in the strongest symptom. So in some cases, patients complain of severe weakness, and there we start with arsenic album. And in some cases, we see patient coming with a chill and headache. The main remedy which I use is gelsemium. And in some cases, we see the body pains, severe body pain from the very beginning. There we start with the Rustox. And in some cases, we are the patient is coming with a severe thirst. And in such cases, we use bryonia. And as I told you earlier, in some cases, it starts with a loose motion or a diarrhea. Usually, I am using Nexomica. Then the next one I usually use is
I think some technical problem happened. Just a moment.
There was some interruption.
Yeah, no.
Okay. I think it is okay now.
Yeah, it's okay now, sir. Yeah.
Okay. So these are the main remedies which I am using for the active phase of this corona fevers, like aconite, belladonna, arsenicum, gelsemium, rostox, bryonia, nexomica, and pulsatilla. Pulsatilla when there is no thirst at all. So these remedies are prescribed on the basis of these symptoms, because instead of going to the all the symptoms of a patient, you know, in acute diseases, we need not have to go into the constitution or a miasm or anything. You can prescribe from the symptomatology or from the etiology. Here we cannot say we don't have a remedy for coronavirus, so etiology is ruled out. And the prescription is based on the symptomatology. Then, usually I am using the 200 potency. I think there in the chat box, there are some questions coming. So what I want to tell you is, please write down the questions now itself. And the last 15 minutes or 20 minutes, we can have a question answer session, which will, I think, more interesting.
Yes.
So then coming back to the topic, so if a patient is coming with severe chill, the two remedies you have to consider is gelsemium and Rustox. Pulsatilla also has chill, but the main remedies are gelsemium and Rustox. Then there are people who are coming with, I told you in the beginning, some maybe it is a gastric flu. Some people come with a severe nausea, not much vomiting, but nausea is there. Then the Ipecac is the best remedy. Then one more important thing which you have to look for is after the, usually what we see is in the first 2 days or the first day itself, the fever goes off and the patient have some other symptoms. Maybe every day we have to change the remedy, because in acute diseases, you know, the symptom changes sometimes very fast from one thing to another. Is it okay?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Because the rain is happening in somewhere.
Maybe because of the heavy rain. Okay, anyway, coming to our topic again. So usually what we see is the symptom, the fever symptom disappears and the patient have severe weakness or something. So that should be taken into consideration. And what I have seen is we have to change the remedy according to the symptomatology. Usually it takes 3 or 4 days only, but later as a complication. Okay, the questions later. Okay, can you hear me? Hello? So here, the usual complications which we see nowadays is some problem with breathing. In such a case, the best remedy is antimonium tartaricum, because it helps the phlegm to come out and clear the lungs. And tuberculum is the miasmatic remedy, because you know, these complications come because mainly of the miasms. When there is a strong tubercular miasm in an individual, he has every chance of getting bronchitis or cough afterwards. In some other people, it is severe weakness. So if there is severe weakness, again, you can think of arsenic alb. And another important remedy is carbovegetabilis. Because in carbovege, what we see is severe weakness and loss of appetite also. And one more thing which many patients complain is loss of smell. Many people identify or diagnose themselves because of this loss of smell. And in such cases, if that is the main complaint, you can think of Pulsatilla, Naxomica, and even nitric acid. So these are the three remedies which you have to think about. In one case, after the fever is over, the patient complained of difficult inspiration. And that was cleared with spongia. Difficult inspiration. So when we talk about in difficult inspiration, I would like to say about a difficult expiration also. If it is difficult expiration, causticum is the remedy. Then in some cases, what we see is it starts with a sore throat, or the main symptom is sore throat in the beginning. And the main remedy that I am using is Aristoxan. Then in some cases, we see headache as a predominant symptom. And then the remedy which we usually, okay, I will repeat it when you can ask questions later, otherwise other people are also. So with headache, if it starts with headache, the remedies which I am giving first is gelsemium, bryonia, or sanguinaria. Then there are people who complain of weight in the chest. Weight in the chest, as if there is something remaining in the chest. That one is phosphorus and bryonia. Then Pulsatilla, all of you know, we prescribe when there is no thirst. That is one of the main things. Then one more thing, Pulsatilla, Naxomica, nitric acid, yes. Then in some cases, what we see is this fever is increasing in the evening. That means by 4 o'clock, it starts and goes up slowly, slowly. And the patient complains that there is evening rise of temperature. In such a case, you have to think of remedies having, among these remedies, remedies having aggravation in the evening. That is sanguinaria, Pulsatilla, carbovege, and tuberculum is the miasmatic or the leading remedy. Then comes the Then the next one is, in some cases we see bone pains. There also you can think of Rostox and Eupatorium. In some cases we find a severe constipation, where you can think of Bryonia and Exomica. And one more thing we have to be very careful is, whenever a patient is coming with comorbidities or some other diseases, you have to keep an eye on that one also. Because usually what we hear now is the death is occurring in people above the age of 60 with the comorbidities. So that we have to be very careful. We have to watch and see whether everything, every other sphere is okay or not. Then the next one is, I would like to say that all the post-COVID syndrome. Now, people are not talking much about that because it is an active phase, but some 2 months back, people were talking about the post-COVID syndrome and how it can be managed. There also, the main issue as post-COVID is, one was severe weakness. Then another one was depression. Then exertional dyspnea. These are the main things which we see. Our loss of smell may prolong for so many days, even after recovering from the COVID fever and everything. So coming to this weakness, the main remedies in weakness is, you know, arsenic album and carbo-vegetables. Then the next one is depression, where you can even use Ignatia or Natramol. Then this exertional dyspnea, whenever they start doing, when they start walking or rising up from the bed or walking, or some people say when they go upstairs, they develop this severe exertional dyspnea. And the main remedies which I have used is arsenic, spongia, calcarea, and carbobage. So these are the remedies which we usually use for post-COVID syndrome. And you all know that the main remedy which is given in our Maitreya Medica for conditions or complications after an acute disease is carbobage and sulfur. These are the two things. So the miasmatic remedies which we have to think about is, the main miasmatic remedies that comes here is tuberculinum and sulfur. Any remedy can come in homeopathy, depending on the condition and everything, but I am just saying this. So I think I have finished, or I have shared with you whatever I am doing. And now I will go to the now where there is a lot of people are asking so many questions to us. We will answer these questions later. So many people are asking questions like they have taken the first dose of vaccination and whether they can take arsenic album, or they have taken the first and second doses of vaccination and whether they can continue our preventive and everything. So the main thing we have to tell them is, because some very educated people are also asking this question. And I usually tell them, see, this vaccine is prepared from a specific virus, which was there 3 months before. Now the mutant varieties are coming. So this vaccination may not be effective for the new variant in COVID. So there comes the use of arsenic album. And even any vaccine, when you look at the whole history of vaccination, the percentage of effectiveness of a vaccine varies from 70 to 80% only. Even though the pharma companies claim 90% or 85%, the actual one is 70 to 80%. And when you look at the flu vaccine, which is very, very common in America, The percentage of effectiveness is only 56%. 56%. Then, in our country also, the vaccine is not given for pregnant women, for children, because they themselves doesn't have the confidence to give it because it is dangerous. So this is one area where we can give our preventives. So just tell the people that for the new variant, this vaccine may not be effective. And it is only homeopathy that can do something. We are not selecting a medicine on the nature of the virus or the type of virus, but we are selecting these medicines depending on the symptomatology. And even the second wave also, we know the symptomatology is almost the same. Not much difference is there. Only thing is it is more virulent type. That's all. So this is the point which we have to emphasize upon. And also there are people who are asking questions like they had an attack of COVID and now whether I should take the preventive or not. There also we can say, tell the same answer that the difference. Now we know that African varieties, the British one is there. Maybe some other ones are there in the world. Maybe in the coming days or coming months, new strains may come. So arsenic alb is one remedy which can be used as a preventive for any type of coronavirus. And it is found very effective also. In my practice, I have given to at least 500 families. And the result is 95% success. And some people, even health workers, health inspectors, who took medicine from me, who had the primary contact with many, many COVID patients. Some of them got it, but it was very mild, and in 3 days' time, it is gone. So just keep in mind all these things, because these are the questions which the public ask us. But above all this, you have to keep an eye if there is comorbidities, especially blood pressure, kidney diseases, people having kidney diseases, blood pressure, diabetes, or something like that, or people who are very weak, where their vitality is very weak, you must be careful. Then, so these are the things which I would like to share with you. And if you have any questions, I'm ready to answer it to the best of my knowledge. And I think the admin can, or somebody can raise their hand in the chat box and ask questions. Thank you. Because in between, so many people were asking questions in the chat box, which I couldn't see properly or answer properly. So this is the time where we can ask questions. You can ask questions, so it will be easier. Hello? Hello, please unmute the people who wanted to ask questions. Here I can see one question, long-standing loss of smell in COVID. See, I told you the main remedies are Pulsatilla and Nexomica. And if it goes on for a longer period, or if this loss of smell is going for a longer period, it is due to the miasmatic involvement, and the remedy is nitric acid. Hello, can you unmute the people who want to ask questions? So many questions are coming in the chat box. One question was, what are the remedies for exertional dyspnea? See, this exertional dyspnea, the medicines are arsenic, spongia, calcarea, natrum moor, and even carbo vegetables. And bryonia also. So for prevention of COVID, somebody has asked the question. Our Central Council for Research in Homeopathy has come up with a very clear guideline for the prevention of COVID. But usually what I usually give is 4 pills of arsenic album for 3 days in early morning, empty stomach. And because of the active state here, I'm giving it or repeating it every 15 days. The genus epidemic is, of course, the arsenic album.
Hello.
Hello. Okay. Anybody wants to ask questions can ask.
Yeah, yeah. Rajini Doctor, you can unmute yourself.
Hello, Doctor. Yes. I am Dr. Ejani from UK. One of the main symptoms after the treatment, especially after allopathic treatment, after coming back from the hospital, they are saying sleeplessness is the main symptom. So what are the medicines we can think of?
In sleeplessness, the main remedy is Nexomica.
Yeah.
But I told you, see, when we look into the complications, okay, what we have to know is the basic remedies are carbovage and sulfur to bring the patient back to his former healthy state. That's why in our material, even after acute disease, it's better to give carbovage or sulfur.
Yeah. Okay.
But the specific one for this sleeplessness is Nexomica.
Okay. Okay. Thank you, sir. Whether we have to give the tincture medicine along with this one?
No, I'm not giving any tincture. I am just giving only one pill of the remedy, 200 potency.
Okay.
When
they were. Okay, thank you, sir.
Who else wants to ask any questions? There are enough questions in the chat box, I think. Dr. Lakshmi, are you?
Hello.
Hello. See, whenever the potency, regarding the potency, there is one question in the chat box. Usually when there is fever, I am giving 200 potency and otherwise 30 potency.
May I ask a question, sir?
Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. My question is, if what about a person who has suffered throat symptoms the previous week with fever, recovered in 3 or 4 days? A week later, again, he redevelops fever and it goes on for about 7 days nonstop. Doctors have finally put him on steroids and blood thinners because they notice a rising D-dimer of 3,300. Now, in event where the blood thinners are going on, what are your thoughts on giving medicines like Arnica or any other, you know, even Proclus H, which has been otherwise advised for the patient? What are your thoughts about it? Or should you, like, is it advisable in the first place to give both together? What would your suggestion be, sir?
Now, the main thing here is, the recurrence of fevers.
Yes.
That is more psoric. Mm-hmm. So the remedies which we usually give when there is a recurrence of fever is one dose of sulfur 200 or tuberculinum 200. Okay. So that can prevent the recurrence of, that means there is the miasmatic aspect behind it. That's why they are getting this recurrence.
Okay.
Then and the next question, one more thing you asked, I forgot it.
No, my question was about the patient is ongoing on Clexane, that is a blood thinner. So is it advisable that we give some homeopathic remedy as well? Because the patient has come to me, patient's relatives have come to me worried that the situation may go a little out of hand. So can we consider giving both? And in that case, what would be the better remedy?
No, the best remedies which we give is, some months back, it was said that the patients are dying because of the clot or like that. The main remedies are Arnica. Yes. And then phosphorus.
Okay, yes, sir. Thank you so much.
Next question.
Dr. Sunita, you can ask the question.
Yes, good evening, sir. Dr. Sunita Pillaiya from Mumbai. Sir, I would like to know, many patients are complaining of nose block during the phase of fever. Along with fever, whenever there is nose block, there is fever. So what is the relation between these two symptoms? And when there is fever, when there is no fever, there is no nose block. And along with fever, they are getting nose block. Sir, this is one question. And second question, throat.
I will answer the first question first.
Okay.
So the main thing is, see, nose block. The main remedies are ammonium carb, Nexomycin. These are the two main remedies. Even after giving one or two doses of Nexomycin or ammonium carb, if the nose block is not completely going off, you can think of giving 2J30 one dose.
Okay, sir.
Next part of your question.
And next part is another case where the fever has settled, the patient's appetite has improved, general well-being has improved, everything is good, but the throat pain is not going away. Now it's already 5-6 days. So only the throat pain is persisting and patient gets irritable when you ask him about the throat pain.
The main remedy for throat pain is Belladonna, Rostox and Heparsulf.
Okay, Heparsulf I did, sir.
Heparsulf is one of the remedies. But you don't get a complete relief, you give a dose of 2.
Okay, yes. Thank you.
Next.
Hello. I think Dr. Jerin, is it possible to unmute
Dr. Jerin? Yeah, I'm unmuting.
Yes, ma'am. Shall I ask my question, ma'am? Sir, am I audible, sir?
Yes.
Sir, research in Homeopathy Kerala has done a research in 140 patients in the second wave, and they have suggested the Pulsatilla to be the genus epidemic, sir. Sir, please tell share your opinion on this.
I did not get much patients, Pulsatilla patients. Okay. I don't know. I cannot say that Pulsatilla is the remedy because, you know, we don't get much results from Pulsatilla. That's why genus epidemicus means a remedy which is found useful or in majority of the cases.
Okay. Dr. Ellery, you can unmute yourself.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
I'd like to ask for this prophylaxis about arsenic album. For how many days or weeks or months do we have to take?
No, I know patients who have taken for 6 months, four months, and it is still working.
Okay, sir. So from your point of view, what will be the ideal time, sir? Ideal timing?
No, ideal time always is early morning empty stomach.
Okay, for how many months, sir?
If you read the chronic diseases, the Hanuman is very clearly explaining that the best time for the administration of a homeopathic remedy is early morning, empty stomach. It's given in our also.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Dr. Ravi, you can ask.
Good evening, sir. Question is now complication of COVID-19 mucormycosis. The medicine for that.
No, what are the symptoms?
The fungal infection.
Fungal infection where? The mouth?
From the hand.
Hand. You can think of Marisol.
Okay, sir. Syphilitic medicine. For that.
Eh?
Syphilitic medicine?
Yeah. Okay. Marisol, you can think of, even tuberculum also you can think of.
Okay, sir. Thank you. Now, in Gujarat, a very dangerous condition in mucormycosis cases. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
So, any more questions, sir? Headache with severe weakness and backache, not much thirst.
Here, what I usually do is we have to identify which one is the strongest symptom or the most distressing symptom. So if it is backache is the main one, you can think of Rostox. But in a headache, if that is the main symptom or most troublesome symptom, you have to think of a remedy which has an equal degree of intensity. And that's why we prefer gelsemium or bryonia in a case of severe headache.
Okay. Anybody want to talk? Then you can raise the hand. I will unmute. Okay. I assume.
Post-COVID medicines to improve appetite. That's one question I saw here.
Yeah.
See, usually patients after recovery, they complain of loss of appetite and weakness, and the best remedy is carbo-vegetable.
So potency 200 or 30?
No, if there is no fever, usually give 30 potency once a day.
Sir, I would like to ask you one question. What would be the apt time to give anti-miasmatic remedies? You have told about sulfur, tuberculum, etc. What is apt time to give that?
The best time is to, after the fever, everything is gone, after they have almost fully recovered, you can think of giving the anti-miasmatic one like tuberculum or sulfur. Because in some cases, after 3-4 days, after the fever has subsided, even after 4 or 5 days, it starts coming back, the fever. So better wait for some time. During that period, we usually give, for recovery, we give carbovage. And after the 1 week, if everything is okay, you can think of giving tuberculum 1 mm or a sulfur 1 mm.
Thank you.
Okay, doctor. Yeah. Sir, there are some questions. I think, is it came back or not? Sir, your experience on Aspergillus tincture.
Aspergillus tincture we were using for some severe conditions of asthma, especially when there is aggravation in the early morning, like 2 or 3, 4 o'clock in the morning. And it was used for, in a way, it was used for anoxia in asthma for so many years. It is being used in homeopathy. But now because of Dr. Ladiga, it became very important and many people are buying it. And I heard that it's not available any of the pharmacies here. But I think the better remedy would be, in my opinion, the better remedy would be carbo-vegetables.
Tick-coated tongue after COVID.
Tick-coated tongue of even antimonium crudum, or actually you can think of as a symptom of symptom.
Okay, sir. Anybody treating any cases? Who can share your queries here, Dr. JC? Okay, Dr. JC, you can unmute yourself.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
Right now I'm practicing in Bangalore. Sir, here when I'm giving two type of cases I'm getting. One is with severe headache, backache, no thirst, but no chill, fever is there. Hello?
Yes, I can hear you.
Severe backache, even the when that symptom comes, the whole family is having the same symptom for everyone.
Yeah, what you said is correct, because in the last 1 week, all the patients who came with COVID either have severe headache or severe backache. Previously, in the first wave, it was not like that. There is some slight change.
Yeah.
And the remedy which I found very useful is gelsemium to start
with.
Gelsemium 200-300 times a day.
Yeah.
And the next remedy is bryonia.
Okay.
And even you can think of sulfur, because sulfur is one of the miasmatic remedy for headache also.
Okay. I have given gelsemium 200. That's better. Because with gelsemium 200, they are getting better. But again, they are telling the backache, headache, and they all are getting better with headache, all other symptoms. But severe backache, they are again telling.
Then, then you have to change the remedy. Because in acute diseases, the symptoms changes often. That's why I said every day we have to get the report from the patient.
Yeah, I'm doing like that.
And depending on the change of symptom, we sometimes have to change the remedy also. So in your case, I think it is better to give a Rostox now.
Okay.
Because now the main symptom has changed from headache to backache.
Yeah, severe backache.
Yeah.
Okay. And in another type of cases, we are getting bryonia. And bryonia, then it's going with the towards the phosphorus, chest congestion, all those things.
Yeah, heaviness in the chest and all.
Yeah, so I'm asking after phosphorus 200, even one case of phosphorus, he's having blurred vision. The spot was there in the field of vision. That all got better with the phosphorus 200. But during this time, he has developed with piles also. Okay, they have suggested him for chromaffin and another hemorrhoid.
No, it's just to go to Nexomycin.
Okay. So I'm asking.
Symptom shifted to the gastric area.
Hmm.
That means basically, the complications come because these complications come in an area where we are weak. The patient is weak.
Yeah.
So everybody. We know the myosin theory and everything, all of you know. So the basic thing is, usually for every individual, there will be a weak organ. And the complication will be manifested on that organ usually. That's why many people who are tubercular myosin, whose lungs are weak, develop lung complaints like bronchitis or anything like that. So here, the piles on the gastric area, so you can give Nexomycin or sulfur.
Okay, so sir, you have told no. After this, whether we can go for carbo wedge as well as the sulfur.
Yes, these are the two remedies which are supposed to be after acute diseases.
Okay. So when they are getting negative, all the symptoms is getting much better. Whether we can. Give this carbo wedge or sulfur.
What I have found is it is better to give carbo wedge because many people have slowness of recovery, slowly recovering, or they feel weak in a way. When we give carbo wedge, the next day itself they will say, "Now I am much better, more I feel more healthy." So carbo wedge is one of my favorite remedies for this.
Okay, so which potency we can add?
If there is no fever, I am usually giving 30 potency of carbovage.
Okay, single dose or how many doses?
I repeat daily for 1 or 2 or 3 days.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Thanks.
Until that weakness is completely gone or
okay,
a new symptom comes up.
Okay.
Is written in our Ken's philosophy.
Yeah.
Ken says the symptom call for the remedy.
Yeah, sure.
Until the body call for the remedy by manifesting some symptom, we have to continue the old one.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thanks a lot.
Dr. Mariam, you can ask the question.
Okay, sir. I have a rheumatoid arthritis patient. She's under immunosuppressant medicines. So now her family member is positive. Today she has developed backache. So what medicine can I give? Because once I gave bryonia, it caused much aggravation in her.
I think backache is, I told you, Rostox is the best remedy that will cover both the backache as well as the rheumatism.
Okay, and headache also she is complaining a little bit.
No, but if backache, see, the main thing in acute condition is we know that in COVID, there are some common symptoms. In every acute, there are 5 to 10 common symptoms. Okay. And out of which, what we are looking for is what is uncommon among the common or which one is stronger. That helps us to individualize the patient.
Okay.
So here, I think your Rostox will work better.
Okay, thank you.
Okay. Dr. Asmin, you can unmute yourself.
Yeah. Sir, I would know. I have a question. What about the patients who are already undergoing a constitution treatment, homeopathic treatment? Should we give the arsenic repeatedly as immunity medicine? Also, if they already get COVID infected, what should be the line of treatment in such patients who are already under treatment?
If they have COVID symptoms, we have to treat it. Then, a patient who is under constitutional treatment is already having an artificial disease in them, and for them, actually, no need of giving a preventive. Clear?
I think she, I think her range, she has some range issue.
So I can't hear, I think I lost connection.
Yeah. Okay.
You want me to repeat? See, if a patient is under your constitutional treatment, his whole system is having an artificial constitutional disease and he may not get an acute disease normally. See, this is explained in by Hanuman in what happens when two dissimilar diseases meet in the body and all those things. So it may not come up in a proper way. So constitutional medicine will give the will act as a preventive also. See, when we give the preventive also, what we are doing is we are creating an artificial similar disease in the individual. Thereby, the natural disease will not affect us. This is the original idea behind giving the preventive. So this constitutional remedy will act as a preventive. But if this patient who is under the constitutional treatment develops COVID, you have to treat that COVID.
Dr. Tejal, you can ask the question.
Yes. Yes, sir. Good evening, sir. I want to ask that role of vanadium and methylene blue in COVID patient. And nowadays in Gujarat, the black fungus is very common and it is just increasing and increasing. Then any medicine for we can prevent, especially in diabetic patient in COVID?
See, vanadium is one remedy to increase the hemoglobin level. But and like our aspirosperma in oxygen level. But I think the better one will be carbovegetables because it works in the, because you know, when there is a complication, don't think that it is a complication one organ only. There are smaller symptoms in the other areas also. So carbovig is a, which is better to select a polycrust that will cover the symptoms in every part of the body.
Yes,
in a, when you read this Kent's philosophy, Kent has written a small book on repertory. There what he says is, if you have four or five remedies under your consideration, give weightage to the polycrust.
Yes, sir. And potency of LA, methylene blue 30 potency, many doctors
Most of these rare remedies are used in lower potencies. It works better.
Yes,
but you have to follow it up with a polycrust or a more deeper acting remedy. Then you can go slowly to the higher potency.
Yes, sir. And especially for black fungus, because number of patients are just increasing like God knows what happened.
No, you can think of, I told you, Marksol is one of the best remedies. When in the mouth, it is antimonium crudum, another remedy. So yes. Like that, you can think about it. Or you just find out the symptoms of that, whether there is an itching, whether there is no itching, whether like that, you can think about it.
Yes, sir. Or any medicine, especially, it is very common in diabetic patient. Then we can give any preventive?
No, preventive the best is, you are talking about after COVID, isn't it?
It is for black fungus only because here
not for the patient who had COVID. Not for the patient who had COVID.
COVID patient,
Isn't it?
Sir.
Yeah, you can give Marksol.
Okay.
Even Rostox can work. But it's better, you know, you have to look into the other symptoms also. That will give you a better choice and better, we will be able to select a better simulacrum.
Yes. Other constitutional
symptoms. See, yes. This fungus is just a sign, but there will be some symptom, you know, yes. Like or washing aggravation or amelioration, hot water, warm, cold water, something like that. So just even location is very important. So like that, you can think about it. For example, in tongue, the main remedies are, you know, nitric acid, calicinatum, like that.
Dr. JC?
Sir, നമ്മള് പോസിറ്റീവ് ആയ കേസസിൽ ന്യൂമോണിയയിലൊക്കെ പോവാണെങ്കിൽ എന്തൊക്കെ മെഡിസിൻ നമുക്ക് തിങ്ക് ചെയ്യാൻ പറ്റുമെന്ന് പറയാം സർ.
See, the first remedy you have to think of in pneumonia is antimonium tartarica. Whenever you think that it is going to the pneumonia state, the first remedy is antimonium tartarica. Second remedy is phosphorus. And in some cases, some authors say it is better to give one dose of tuberculinum first, 200 or 1 mm, and then go to this remedy. Because see why there is such a thing developing. It is a complication. It is a tubercular, it happens in a patient who is having tubercular myosin as a predominant one in him. That's why it is going to the lungs and producing complication on that area, lungs. So some others say, give a dose of tuberculum first, then you go to the indicated remedy. That means to prevent the myosin from taking over. Or you can start with an antimonium tartaricum or a phosphorus and later go to tuberculum. These are the two remedies which are found very useful, three remedies, that is antimonium tartaricum, phosphorus, and tuberculum.
Sir, tuberculum 1 mm, sir, varayin?
200 or 1 mm.
Okay. Inna, sir, chela cases ilipo, abdominal complaints in the kude, randu unna cases ilo dysuria like symptoms na different ayirna.
Yeah. It comes in people who are psychotic.
Okay, sir.
So the main remedies are Cantharis Thuja.
Okay. Okay, thank you, sir.
Thank you.
So there, in case of COVID patient in ICU on by which is the best way to administer our medicine?
No, some people come and ask for the medicine, and I also used to give, and they gave it also. Because, you know, whatever they are doing is just paracetamol and vitamin C. Whatever, wherever they are put, whether it is in ICU or a common ward, usually what they are giving is paracetamol and vitamin C.
Dr. Saida, you can unmute, okay? She was asking something for some. Hello.
Hello.
Hello. Dr. Vidisha. Okay, you can unmute.
Good evening, sir. Sir, could you please guide how to choose sulfur or tuberculinum? As you said that we should conclude with an antimiasmatic. Could you please guide how to choose this drug?
Okay. See. Sulfur is the king of antisorics, and tuberculum is the king of tubercular myosin. So here, how you will differentiate between these two? See, the main thing is a recurrence of complaint is soric. You follow me? Recurrence of complaint is soric, and all the inflammations are soric. So sulfur comes there. Then, when tuberculum comes, that is the next question. Tuberculum comes when this acute patient or a patient having an acute disease start getting a complication in the from the tubercular myosin. Follow me. So when it starts affecting the lung, you can think of tuberculum, like a cough or dyspnea or something, you can think of tuberculum. So, or if fever is coming back again and again, you can think of sulfur, because the periodic recurrence of complaints is sulfur. Fever is an inflammatory condition which comes under sora. So there comes sulfur.
Sir, and one more question, sir. So we get patients where we are practicing in Baroda, me, myself and my husband. We have majority of the patients, we are giving homeopathy and as well as they are taking allopathic drugs. Most of the, after 15 to 14 days of quarantine, the reports are normal, but D-dimer is still high. So few patients find it difficult to resume their offices because until the reports are normal, they are not allowed to resume. Can we prescribe some medicine for D-dimer levels?
No, it is ideal. You can give sulfur or tuberculum there. Even thuja, because in viral diseases, the main myasome is psychotic myasome. And you can think of thuja also. So there, what you have to do is either you go to the miasmatic remedy or to the constitutional remedy.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Okay. I think the sir, can we then bind up the session?
Okay, okay. So, thank you all for the patient hearing and your wonderful.
Yes.
And thank the organizers, Russell, Deepu, everybody. And thank you for the IHMA Theravam unit because I was a state president of the IHMA from 1997 to 2000. And most of the people I know, but the youngsters, I was out of India for a long time, so I am not in touch with the youngsters. Thank you all for the patient hearing and for giving me this opportunity. Thank you all.
We express our sincere gratitude, sir. Actually, it was a short session. We just came, we fixed in yesterday only, but we got around more than 250, 230 doctors all over the India. So I'm really happy that this session really helped them. And I thank all the doctors who joined us and keep follow us and be a member. And we will come. We are coming up with some interesting sessions. And thank you all. Thank you, sir. Once again.
Thank you.